Welcome to the first episode of Kotlin Standard Library Safari. My name is Sebastian, and I'll be your guide through the features which you get out of the box with Kotlin. If you know how to wield it, the Kotlin Standard Library is a powerful tool which can help you be more productive solving your problems and be more expressive in your code. So in this series, we're going to take a look at useful functionality the standard library in Kotlin has to offer. And in the process, we're going to unearth some hidden gems together, which will come in handy the next time you write Kotlin code. In today's episode, we're going to be talking all about strings, how we manipulate them, extract information, compare them, and much more. After watching this, I hope we'll all be lords of the strings. So yeah, let's strap in, folks, and let's get going. Now, strings are one of the most prevalent data types that you've probably come in touch with. After all kinds of information gets stored in the form of text strings, one way or another. Probably even in your first ever Kotlin program, you had a string literal saying hello world or something like it. But as you may know, even string literals can do just a little bit more in Kotlin than just statically store some text. With string interpolation, we can enrich our strings by referencing variables, calling functions, or even evaluating complex expressions. And when our strings contain multiple lines of text or special characters that are usually reserved, like quotation marks or backslashes, we can use multi-line strings, which are denoted by triple quotes. And everything just behaves as expected. When you type out multi-line strings in IntelliJ IDEA, you can notice that a call to trim indent is automatically added to the string. This function removes the common indent of all input lines and also removes the first and last lines if they're blank. So if we have some XML or JSON stored in a string, we can keep the nice formatting in our code without having to worry about introducing additional characters. And for those performance gurus among you who might be worried about invoking an extra function when creating a string, fear not, for constant strings this transformation is evaluated at compile time with no runtime overhead. Of course, there are tons of other places where strings could come from. Kotlin can read terminal input via the readLine function, for example. We could read text from a file and tons of other ways. Another neat way of creating Kotlin strings yourself is via the buildString function. We can give the function a code block which populates a string builder with functions like append and appendLine, which is particularly useful if you're crafting large strings and performance is a concern. And there is a lot we can do with all these strings. Next to some functionality like lower or uppercasing a string, Kotlin also comes with functions that are particularly useful when we want to extract information from strings. That usually means removing anything that isn't useful. For example, we might want to detect strings that don't contain any real information at all. So empty strings that have no characters in them, or blank strings that only contain white space. To check whether we have this kind of string, we can use the isBlank and isEmpty functions. We can also conveniently replace those empty and blank strings with default values via the ifBlank and ifEmpty functions. Here we can add a block which generates a default value for our strings. And when we do have a string with meaningful content, but that information is surrounded by white space, we can use the trim function to remove empty space from the beginning and the end of our string. If there are some other characters or maybe a common phrase which we don't really care about at the sides of the text, there are more functions which are our allies. Remove prefix, remove suffix, and remove surrounding. With those, we can get rid of the characters in the front, in the back, and enclosing the text. Another big way of extracting information from strings is via regular expressions, or short regexes, but this is a bit of a bigger topic, so we'll see if we can cover those in an extra video. So now that we know some tricks of how to get strings containing only our information, we can do things like compare strings with each other. Equality checks are easy enough, with the double equal sign checking whether two strings are identical. But did you know that you can also compare two strings based on their alphabetical order? This can be done by using the less than and greater than signs. In situations where we want to compare two strings regardless of how their text is capitalized, we can use the compare to and equals function with the ignore case parameter set to true. It looks a bit nicer than calling two lowercase on both strings individually, right? And it has better performance as well. But often strings also contain multiple pieces of information which we would like to work with individually. So to rip apart a string into its pieces, there's a number of options. Most generally, the split function is our friend here. We can specify a character, a word, or some other string which will be used as a splitter, and the function gives us a nice list of the individual string pieces cut up by our delimiter. And if we only want to make a limited number of cuts, we could also pass a limit to the split function. And then we'll only get 3 pieces of text as a result, for example, with the last piece being the remainder of the string, which wasn't split any further. For the special case of splitting a string up by lines, there's the very accurately named lines function, which gives you back your text, you may have already guessed it, line by line. The nice part here is that we don't have to remember the escape sequence for new lines. Was it \r\n? Who cares? We have the lines function. And of course, we can do all sorts of fancy things once we have a collection. And to be exact, even an individual string behaves like a collection. Because, well, it's a collection of characters. On the one hand, this means that we can use the array operator to pick out characters at specific indexes, which can be quite useful. But it also means that stuff like mapping, filtering, and friends all work directly on strings as well. But those collection operations are going to be part of a future episode, because they're definitely worth their own video. So if you don't want to miss me talking about those in one of the next videos, make sure to subscribe to the channel and maybe even hit the notification bell so you get updates on when we publish a new video. Well, and that's already everything I have for you today. I hope you enjoyed this brief overview of things to do with strings in Kotlin. You've seen some hand-picked highlights of working with text, but there's of course a bunch more stuff you can do, which I encourage you to explore on your own, for example, in the documentation on text. If you know some extra string-related tips you'd like to see featured in a future episode, make sure to share them on Twitter with me, @sebi_io and @kotlin. And maybe we'll see your tip in another video. But this is all the content we have time for today. For now, I'm signing off, and I hope that all of you will explore some more Kotlin. Take care.